In this graph, we want to look at the Frank Starling mechanism. And the Frank Starling mechanism is a length tension relationship for cardiac muscle. What this means is that the resting length, the pre-contraction length of cardiomyocytes, partially determines the strength with which they contract. This is true due to changes in the sarcomere that occur as we stretch that striated muscle. Stretching enhances the number of cross bridges that are formed, enhancing the degree of tension, and in this case, increasing our stroke volume. And so we're plotting stroke volume relative to our EDV, our end diastolic volume. Now, end diastolic volume would be the filling volume, and therefore directly proportional to the stretch of those cardiomyocytes. It's also referred to as the preload on these cardiomyocytes. Now, we can see at a normal preload, or EDV, of about 130 milliliters, we would generate a normal stroke volume of about 70 to 80 milliliters. As we increase filling, though, as EDV rises, we're going to stretch that muscle to a greater degree and get a harder contraction that will eject more blood from the heart. This, of course, would increase cardiac output, right? If stroke volume goes up, so too will cardiac output. Now, when does this occur? Well, there's a couple different scenarios. Exercise would be a good example of when cardiac output needs to rise. Cardiac output, one of the rationale or reasons that cardiac output will go up during exercise is that skeletal muscles contract and compress the veins that pass through them. This pushes blood more rapidly back into the central veins, driving it into the ventricles and increasing EDV. This is very important for matching inflow and outflow of the heart, right? We drive more blood back to the heart, and this enhances the output and therefore the flow to those working skeletal muscles. Another example would be people with intrinsically low heart rates. Endurance athletes, for example, have lower heart rates than normal due to enhanced parasympathetic output. Well, just because your heart rate is low doesn't mean that they can survive on a lower cardiac output. They need the same oxygen delivery and nutrient delivery and other factors at rest that normal people do. And so their heart rate might be dramatically lower than average, but in response, they have more time to fill between those heartbeats. More filling means greater EDV. Greater EDV means a larger stroke volume with each contraction, which of course keeps their cardiac output in the normal range. Finally, another example would be changes in blood volume. Many of the hormones that regulate blood pressure actually regulate blood volume. And one of the mechanisms of doing that is by regulating urine volume. So for instance, some hormones will minimize urine volume, helping us to retain water. This increases blood volume, a big portion of which ends up in the high compliance venous circuit. This increases central venous pressure, which drives blood flow back to the heart, which increases EDV, driving us to the right again, enhancing our stroke volume. And so those hormones enhance stroke volume and cardiac output. And as we can see, cardiac output is a component helping us regulate blood pressure, right? Cardiac output times total peripheral resistance will equal our blood pressure. And so by enhancing blood volume, we increase our stroke volume through the Frank Starling mechanism. Cardiac output goes up, which makes blood pressure go up.